we see, and what we see is our image of the world. But when we see, we also remain on the surface. Looking inward, into ourselves, is something our eyes cannot do on their own. For three men, this wasn't good enough. James Fujimoto, Eric Swanson, and Robert Huber. They all played a part in this invention.
O.
Optical.
C. Coherence. T.
Tomography.
O.
C.
T.
OCT has revolutionized ophthalmology and is increasingly used in many other areas. The machine shines a laser beam into the eye. Part of this light is reflected from different layers of tissue. The computer measures this echo time delay of light and generates a depth-resolved image of the tissue, like a tomographic scan, showing cross-sectional structures with microscopic resolution. The exam is fast, safe, extremely gentle, and has many advantages.
OCT essentially performs optical biopsy. It can perform imaging of pathology at micrometer resolutions. The imaging can be done in situ without having to remove a specimen as an excisional biopsy.
OCT has allowed doctors to peer into living tissue in ways they couldn't do before.
OCT overcomes the limits of our vision, not only by means of state-of-the-art technology, but also with a new way of seeing. For our eyes, this is a notepad. We look down at it from above, but there's something we can't do. On page one, you can't see what's written on page four. And that is exactly what OCT can do. OCT is a method that measures from what depth any light reflections have come. Measuring the transit time of the light enables a three-dimensional image to be generated. The image, simple at first glance, is actually a miracle of optical technology. OCT images tissue structure, precise to within a few thousandths of a millimeter, in all three dimensions. James Fujimoto pioneered this technology at MIT in Boston back in the 1980s. To develop and commercialize this medical technology, he assembled a powerful team.
These days, it's much more common to have a multidisciplinary collaborative team. But back in the mid-1980s and early 1990s, when we started work, this was quite unusual.
His approach turned out to be extremely effective. It was how the optical communication technology expert Eric Swanson joined his team. The first prototype was created, but it had not been tested on human subjects yet.
I remember when it came time to do the first in vivo human OCT experiment. We were sitting around in a room and I was wondering who was going to go first. After all, we were going to shine a laser right on somebody's retina. And before I could finish that thought, Professor Fujimoto sat down, took off his glasses, put his hand on the chin rest and said, "Let's go." And I thought, wow, that was courageous.
The instrument was safe and could image the human retina with unprecedented resolution. James Fujimoto and Eric Swanson translated it from the MIT laboratory to industry in 1996.
Eric was involved in co-founding the first OCT startup companies. Eric is an extremely accomplished entrepreneur.
The results speak for themselves.
OCT is one of the most commonly used imaging procedures in ophthalmology. There are about 30 million OCT scans performed every year worldwide. That's one every few seconds.
The fruits of successful pioneering work, and the potential is far from exhausted.
One of the wonderful things about OCT is you can deliver the laser light in a tiny optical fiber, and you can place that fiber into various medical instruments and things like this endoscope. And using probes like this, you can image hard-to-reach places within the human body.
For example, doctors can see blood vessels and other organs from the outside and the inside. They can visualize plaque inside coronary arteries and generate 3D maps to guide and customize treatment, like this stent, which is used to restore blood flow in a blocked artery. The economic potential is enormous.
The economic impact of OCT has been exceptional. Today, the system market is approaching $1 billion a year. There are over 16,000 high-quality jobs, and it saved billions of dollars in unnecessary healthcare expenditures.
And the success story continues with laser physicist Robert Huber. Between 2003 and 2006, as a postdoctoral associate in Fujimoto's group, he developed ultra-fast laser technology that dramatically improved OCT performance.
Robert's technique enabled a 10 to 100 times increase in imaging speed.
His technology was the breakthrough. For the first time, three-dimensional volumetric images can now be generated in real time. This innovation promises to provide more accurate diagnostics, as well as enable new, minimally invasive surgical procedures. All of them generated from millions of OCT depth scans per second and visualized in three dimensions. Robert Huber is the next generation of researcher. Together with Eric Swanson and James Fujimoto, their story of OCT shows the power of multidisciplinary collaboration and innovation.